Hello and welcome to a new tutorial. This video is an extension to my last tutorial in which I showed the new 2D function on Facebook. Today I will show you how I create the 3D scale map for the picture. For this reason I got one of my characters. For this time I just used the PNG file, not the Photoshop file, so you can do it with every picture. For the start I will block out the areas like the arms or the head to separate them from the picture so I can better work. In this state I don't really care about the depth, I do this later. Just block out the things you want separate. You can just draw over this. I recommend to turn down the opacity a bit so you can look through the picture you do draw. Often it helps to use the magic wand to separate the pieces. So the next block come on another layer in a different color. Just block everything out. Next thing, next layer. So for the block out you have to keep in mind what you want to keep in front and what keeps in the back. For this, their little holes will be a little more in the back. So I separate them for the rest of the picture. So now block out is done. Now we can show what's in front. So what we make, a brighter color, a brighter gray or white. And what's in the back means which becomes dark. Right? Background is in the back, so it's dark. Makes sense. And now we must show which one is in the front. To change the color you just can use the paint bucket tool. In Photoshop, sometimes it can happen, the paint bucket tool makes your selected area a little bigger. To avoid this, I use the adjustment layers. And with the lighter and darker tone, you can make it darker or brighter. Notch down or keep it open as you like. Next one is the head. I have these all on one layer, so separate them. Maybe the lasso tool makes more sense. left ear is more on the back. Much down. Mouth and eyes, they are too dark, so they will really become hollow. For the most time, it is better to look at when the color itself is not in a big difference. It kinda looks weird. You can sadly don't see the grayscale together with your picture on Photoshop. I don't have these 3D options, so we have to test it. So, save this. For saving, you have to name them both the same name, and the grayscale must have in the end _ depth. So now we check if it works. Facebook. So. Again. Just a test, so don't have to upload it. Both in there. Full picture. So, there's the picture. So we can see. Okay, the background, that's too far behind, it's really stretched out. But the character itself works okay. You make it a few changes, then it looks better. But the rough blockout works. So, okay. So, now the fine tuning. To give us a little more effect. At the moment it's just the shapes really roughly blocked out. To add a little depth, you can add gradients into it. So, okay, give one. We start with a head. It's a cartoon figure, it looks nice when there is a little roundness to see. So in Photoshop we do a clip mask, so we only work on the shape beneath it. Brush with soft round tip. Okay. Opacity and pressure sensitivity. And just a small circle around them. Don't have to be a big. Changing colors. It's kinda dark at the moment, so turn down the opacity. It's enough. This is just a fine color, it will come out and don't look too weird. So that next one, the eyes. New layer, mask, my clip mask. So I have the mouth and the eyes on the same, so I roughly select them. Just a little. So they appear a little rounder. My mouth can stay. Next one, eyebrows. Okay, next one, eyebrows and ear. Same thing, select. So, then a little, yeah, a little too dark. Just a little darker. Interesting. Okay, so. Next one, the ear. So, then the teeth. There should be a little rounder too. So, make the edges a little darker. Ah, it's too. The variation is too deep, it don't look good. So, just little color shifts. So. Next for under dress. We had a little gradient here too. No knit, not drawing. So separate. And you see the hat is still dark a little bit. And the ear it could work, but in the head if the color is too different it looks weird. So the dress. Same thing, this is the back. So smooth gradient, same on the back, right. Next, right on front. And dark on the back. So, on the arm, not just select the arm. So, we don't want to look, it's disconnected from the rest of the body, so we have to blend it here. It's a little bit, it's okay, it's fine. Then add the little gradient. That roundness of the edges. Same for the other arm. So it's in the back, it don't have to have the exact color, just a similar. Pick a brush. And this goes back. And do the little mist. So let's test this version. Same file save as PNG or JPEG. And where is it? Yeah. Save. Yes. Okay. Then test it again on Facebook. So new test. You see, the figure works good. Everything stays in place. Just the background have some issues. So, brighten up just a little. And with the background you can see what happens when the color variation from dark to bright is too big. It makes weird stuff with the picture. New test. So, the fine-tune is just trial and error. Works better. Not the best. But I don't want to make it brighter, then it's the same as the arm. I leave it in this. So, but no. Give it a proper name. Thank you. answer and share it with the world. Hey, it works! So, this was the end of the tutorial. You see, with the block out you can work easier and change things faster and make the grayscale for every picture working. So, thanks for listening and have a nice day!